Buenos días.
Good morning. We are here once again to answer the questions posed by journalists from all over the world with regard to recent events in which our country decided to discontinue its participation in the More Doctors for Brazil program. I remind you that we are broadcasting live in Spanish and that once this transmission concludes, we will be airing it in Portuguese and English. This time, we will address some issues related to the development and evolution of Cuba's medical cooperation. It is important to go to the essentials, to look at figures, and analyze the results, to be able to understand the reason behind the presence of Cuban health professionals in Brazil and elsewhere in the world where they offer their services. First, I would like to emphasize that Cuba's national health system is based on solid and broadly validated principles. In Cuba, health care is considered a right of the people. It is a universal, free of charge, and quality service that is also a responsibility of the state. Healthcare services are provided equally to the entire population. Health practice is based on solid scientific evidence, and all actions are prevention-oriented. Social participation is inherent to the management and development of health services. As part of that system, we cannot but mention international cooperation, which is built upon established ethical standards and a profoundly humanistic, selfless, and altruistic praxis. It is only on the basis of these principles that Cuba has been able to achieve, after 55 years, the results that it can exhibit today. Cuban professionals have accomplished 600,000 internationalist missions in 164 countries, which have involved the participation of more than 400,000 health workers, who, in quite a few cases, have carried out this task more than once. Only in 2018, 36,000 cooperation workers have been offering their services in 67 countries. Of them, 18,000, that is half of the overall total, are medical doctors. Therefore, Cuba's international cooperation develops by combining the potential of all the countries involved, following a not-for-profit principle and taking into account the existing differences and asymmetries. The presence of our cooperation workers in 67 nations of the world has responded to the express requests of recipient countries and has always been based on a cooperative agreement signed by competent institutions and consistent with the cooperation vocation Cuba has shown during the last 60 years. In some cases, this has included the participation of such organizations as the World Health Organization and the Pan American Health Organization. The international cooperation that Cuba offers relies on the principles of solidarity and mutual benefit. This is an essential aspect of the foreign policy of the revolution. These actions contribute to the economic and social development of our country. Cuba's cooperation is offered without political preconditions and with absolute respect for the principles of international law. That is to say, with absolute respect for the sovereignty, the laws, culture, religion, and self-determination of states. It is not used as a political instrument to interfere in the internal affairs of states. Health professionals and technicians devoted particularly to primary health care take part in this cooperation on a voluntary basis. They offer their services to the entire population, regardless of their race, religious beliefs, and ideology, without getting involved in domestic politics issues and observing the laws and customs of the countries where they work. Given its institutional character, it is intended to benefit as many persons as possible and is developed in the most remote and neglected areas, where this service is not provided by the local institutions. This selfless assistance that is offered in solidarity with other peoples of the world contributes to improve and strengthen the national health system. It allows Cuban health professionals to gain more experience, awareness, and be more dedicated and committed to themselves, their families, and the people. Cuba's medical cooperation is a cardinal element in the international recognition and respect earned by our country. No money in the world can buy what our health professionals are doing. They undoubtedly carry with them the humanistic essence of the revolution. We will now answer some of the questions that we have received through the email vocero@minrex.gob.cu. This is an email that we have made available to the media. We will now go for a short break, and we will come back immediately after that.
Me acompaña en esta emisión el doctor.
I am joined on this broadcast by Dr. Jorge Delgado Bustillo, Director of the Central Unit of Medical Cooperation of the Ministry of Public Health Care of Cuba, whom I thank for being here with us. We have grouped the questions that we have received as the interests raised by the media repeat themselves. And the first question that has been raised by several Brazilian reporters and other international media concerning the stipend Cuban doctors receive, and they're asking for more information on the contribution to Cuba by each doctor through their internationalist mission. Well, our internationalist doctors have served in 64 countries, and they have earned an immense prestige because what they have carried is humanism, solidarity, and altruism. They have actually come very close to the countries and the peoples, both in Brazil and in many other countries around the world. Let me just say that more than 1.7 billion consultations have been offered by our doctors in these years of medical missions. And it's been done directly treating their patients with humanism and sensitivity, as we do here in Cuba. This is the way we do it anywhere else in the world. In Brazil, our countries have gone to the hardest to reach area, the most difficult places where the local doctors or other foreign doctors wouldn't go. And there is always a guarantee that the Cuban doctors will serve in those places. 113 million of medical consults have been offered by our doctors in Brazil with high impact results. We've learned of studies that have been conducted whereby 95% of the population have rated the medical assistance of Cuban doctors as positive. And of course, in Cuba, our family doctors and all health professionals receive their salaries. We get our salary when we go on internationalist mission, and what they get in those countries is a stipend. It is important to mention that everything is guaranteed in Cuba for the doctors' families, their parents, their children. They have their medical and social assistance available for them so that the doctors can go on their missions with a peace of mind and only concentrated on their work. They know that their rear guard is covered by the state and their family. Therefore, we get a certain revenue as a result of this medical cooperation in Brazil. What do we use that for? In order to maintain our free, universal health system, when being a country under a blockade, it becomes more and more difficult to get inputs and advanced technology and state-of-the-art medications to save more Cuban lives, and that takes money. And our people only have to go to the hospital. They don't have to spend money on this. And we get this revenue not only from Brazil, but also from other countries. And these funds go into making our national health system more robust. 19,225 general practitioners, family doctors, as we call them, have served in this country. Very well, thank you. Also, the media is interested on the numbers of the arrivals of doctors in our country. Could you please give us an update on how many health professionals have already returned, and particularly how this process is organized and how long it is expected to take? As we speak, we have received 9 flights coming from Sao Paulo, and 1,875 general practitioners have arrived in our country. They have come in an orderly and safe fashion, and they're being gathered in some hubs like Brasilia, Sao Paulo, Manaus, and Salvador de Bahia. In fact, the first flight from Salvador to Salvador de Bahia left today, and tomorrow they will be bringing some doctors. And I can say that all controls are being done there, and when they arrive in Cuba, in our Jose Marti International Airport, there is an official welcoming ceremony with the attendance of government and party authorities, as well as members of the people and officials from several organizations. And there's a whole organization in place so that the safely return of the doctors is also safe here. And they're being paid tribute because of the responsibility and the duty that they have accomplished. They come back to Cuba knowing that they have done their duty and regretting that they have to leave them, not because they want. These respond to a number of other reasons which have forced the Ministry of Health to take this decision. At the airport, in their provinces, and in the communities, in the polyclinics, and the workplaces, and in their neighborhood, they are they're giving a warm welcome. Let us now respond to some of the people who have asked about the relocation process of the Cuban doctors when they have returned and about upcoming foreign assignments for these professionals. Fidel has taught us that you can never have too many doctors. You can never have too many doctors for Cuba or for the world. In the World Health Assembly in May this year, our Minister of Public Health presented to the General Secretary of WHO the willingness of more than 10,000 Cuban doctors to go and help people around the world. And we were already there in Brazil, but in addition to that, we're willing to help elsewhere. You can never have too many doctors, not in Cuba or elsewhere. I believe that the infant mortality rate of 3.9 per 1,000 live births, which is one of the lowest in the world, is the direct result of the work of our general practitioners and family doctors and the maternal and child care program. When the doctors return, they have their jobs ready. They will continue to work as doctors in Cuba. But in addition, they will be offered language studies and a second medical specialty without losing sight of the fact that general practitioners can solve and respond to 80% of the health issues of a community, and the rest 20% is in the hospital. But 80% is solved by the general practitioners. So they will engage in other medical specialties and in language studies like English and French, because we have to continue our cooperation who speak those languages. We have a question regarding the expenses that have to be incurred by the returning Cuban professionals. The Cuban professionals incurred in no expenses when they are coming back to our country. This is an orderly return which is being coordinated between the Cuban Medical Brigade and PAHO. And all of the arrangements have been made in order to gather the doctors in the hubs. They incurred in no expenses. From Telesur English, we get a question concerning the education and training of Brazilians in Cuba and whether there will be a change in this regard. There will be no change. As has been done throughout these years, Brazilians who are interested to come to Cuba will do so as established. This relationship with the Brazilian people will not be estranged. Quite on the contrary, it will become closer for the peoples of Cuba and Brazil to be closer together. And everything will continue to go just as it has so far. there are no changes in this connection. Thank you, doctor. With these questions, we come to the end of this broadcast. The email address, vocero@minrex.gov.cu, will remain active for your questions. The Portuguese and English language versions of this broadcast will be made available soon. I thank you all for your attention. Have a good day.